present here. Myself, K. Christie Jennifer, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Costume Design and Fashion. Today, I am going to take a topic which is called as wet processing. So, what is wet processing? Wet processing involves the terms which is done by using mechanical and chemical treatments. So, wet processing is done by using mechanical or chemical treatments. So, mechanical is nothing but when you are using only the instruments or equipments, it will be considered as a mechanical treatments. And while you are using some chemicals and applying the finishing, then it is called as chemical finishes. For example, water, then chlorine. So likewise, we can introduce any chemical treatments to the entire fabric. So wet processing is done only to give the aesthetic values. So what is aesthetic values? So while the material is produced for some finishes to introduce an end use, then it is called as aesthetic values. For example, if you want to change the feel of the fabric, we have to give some mechanical or either chemical treatments to give an end product. So that is called as aesthetic values. And there is another type of values which is called as functional. So function is nothing but the additional finishes which can be introduced in the fabric for giving a specific finish. For example, antimicrobial finishes, for example, anti-static finish or flame retardant. So likewise, we are introducing a functional finishes based upon the necessity of the fabric. So these two finishes are very essential in our textile industry. So to introduce these finishes, we have to compulsorily give the wet processing treatment. And we can ask another question, why it is called as wet processing? Because wet is the term we called as water treatments. Around 85% of treatment is done by using water. So that is why it is called as wet processing. So I will give the classifications of wet processing. So how we classify this wet processing? So we classify into three. We are classifying the wet processing into three segments. The first one is preparatory process, second one is coloration, and third one is finishing. So these three processes are very, very essential for treating the fabrics. So first one is preparatory. Where we are introducing the preparatory? We are introducing the preparatory in the initial stage. Wet processing is divided into three segments. So first one is preparatory process, second one is coloration, and final one is finishing. So what is preparatory? While fabric is introduced from the loom, we have to give some further treatments to give the end uses. For that is called as preparatory. It is very essential for our textile industry. The second one is coloration. Coloration involves the dyeing or printing or any other paintings or embroidery, whatever it is coming in the fabric, it will come under coloration process. The final one is finishing. So this is the application of the fabric. What purpose we are introducing the fabric? That purpose, for that we have been giving some specific finishes. So that will come under finishing treatment. So in this, I am going to give the classifications of preparatory process. So initially, we are using the raw material which is called as grey fabric. So grey fabric is introduced in the preparatory process. Then second one is singeing. So second pre-treatment is called as singeing process. Third one is desizing. The next one is scoring. And the next one is bleaching. So in preparatory, we are introducing these four processes which is very, very essential for our textile industry. And the second one is coloration. For coloration, we are introducing, we can apply by using the method called as dyeing, or we can go for printing, or we can go for painting, any other coloring process. So this is the second method to enhance our fabrication. Then third one is the finishing. So finishing, for example, we can use it mercerization process. So mercerization is nothing but the giving luxury to the fabric, and the next is embossed finishing. So there are many types of finishes. So like this, we are dividing the criteria into three segments. So I am going to explain about the completely the preparatory process. So preparatory, I am explaining the topics once again: gray fabric, singeing, desizing, scouring, and bleaching. Let me discuss about these topics. So elaborately, now we can see what are all the preparatory process. So first one I told you, singeing. So I will give you a brief note on singeing. What is singeing? Here singe means to burn. So singe is nothing but to burn. So why we are introducing singeing? Because while the fabric is woven or knitted, we can give it two types of fabrics. One is woven and another one is knitted fabric. While we are going for woven, the fabrics will be two yarns are used for weaving the fabrics. One is warp yarn and another one is weft yarn. So warp yarn, while introducing in the loom, we are applying this starching, and many ingredients are used to weave the fabrics. So the process is carried out in loom. While process is carried out in loom, we are introducing many types of handlings. So to remove all the extra materials or matters in the fabric, we have to go for this preparatory process. So in that, we are introducing singeing. So singeing is nothing but to burn. So what is to burn? The protruding fibers. Protruding fibers on the fabrics should be burned so that we can get a clear surface on the fabric. Clear surface on the fabric. We can feel the fabric in a smooth way. And while you are giving your printing or embroidery, we can get the sharp edges. So to get these advantages, we have to burn the protruding fibers. So protruding fibers is nothing but the fibers which is protrude on the entire fabric. So we have to burn this. So to burn this, we are introducing this singeing process. So how it can be done? It can be done by using three methods. So one is, I will give you in the next slide. So first one is hot plate method. Hot plate method. Second one is roller method. And third one is gas singeing. So these three methods are used in singeing treatment. So first one is hot plate method, second one is roller method, and third one is gas singeing. I already told that what singeing process is carried out to burn the protruding fibers. How we are burning the fibers? We are burning by using some plates or some rollers or by using the gas. So this method is completely a dry process. It is called as dry process. Here we are using only mechanical method. Mechanical method. So there is no need of any water or no need of any chemicals. Only by using drying process we are introducing this singeing method, and it is a purely a mechanical finish. So here first I will elaborate the hot plate method. So hot plate is a material which is made up of steel, and here we can burn the protruding fibers by using heat. We are generating heat in the steel, and the fabric will pass over the steel materials so that we can burn the only the protruding fibers without damaging the entire fabric. So what will happen? We will change all the properties of the surface of the fabric. So it will be ready for the next process. So material used is steel, and we are introducing heat, and how many materials can be burned at a time? We can burn 200 yards of fabric per minute, but it is a slow process. So the drawback is it is a very slow process. And while coming to the next one, roller method. So roller method is made up of copper cylinder. It is made up of copper cylinder or iron. So we can use two things of materials to enhance the singeing process. Here the cylinder will cover the entire fabric and it will also produce the heat and it will start to burn the protruding fibers, and it is also a slow method. The same drawback we see in roller method. The third one is gas singeing. So gas singeing is popularly used method. What is gas singeing? While we are burning the fabric by using some gas, so then it is called as gas singeing method. So gas singeing method has a many advantages. It's a time consuming method, and we can burn both sides at a time. Both sides. So the main drawback for hot plate or roller is we can burn only the outer surface of one side. Again, entirely the process will be come from reverse. So once we are burning the right side of the fabric, again the fabric has to replace and again it has to be burned for second time. So the work will carried out for entire fabric twice the time. So it is waste of time and it's a very slow process. While coming for roller, the same method. Once the fabric has been finished, again it has to be rearranged and it has to be finished once again. But for gas singeing, we can burn the fabric both the sides. So after that we can finish it off and the time will consume. So this is called as gas singeing method.